also become the first woman from Jammu and Kashmir to scale the mountain. In addition to this, she is a former Miss India finalist from 1985. She is also the founder, director, and image consultant of Impact Image Consultants. So Sangeeta, you're clearly unstoppable. Even at the age of 53, to have scaled a mountain, I'm sure I can't do that if I want to today. Yeah? Hello, ladies and gentlemen. What an evening. I see so many great women here, all getting empowered. And we get empowered by listening to other people's stories. I'll give you a little roundup about my own life. I come from Jammu and Kashmir, Jammu as being my state. And when I was born, it was a very small state, as you know, conservative, people knew each other. So there was hardly any reason why I would follow what I saw in my own house. My mother got married at about 17, and I didn't want to do that because I only saw her, being a mom and working. And I said, what's the point of having education? So the seed was born then, when I thought I have to be different. So that different meant being unique and taking charge of your own life in whatever way you can. So as all girls do when they are growing up in their teenage years, what do they want? They want to get into modeling, they want to fly as an air hostess, and that was my dream. So at 16, that was a dream that was pinned on my, you can say it was a vision board that I had, and I used to see these crew going from A to B. So I told my parents and I said, I want to become an air hostess, and they said, there's no way, girls from our families don't do that, which is still the case in many, many countries and many, many places in India. But here I want to talk about in short 3 points that your life can be what you want it to be. So the passion is one, the preparation is second, and third is perseverance. So my life started with becoming an air hostess. I failed 4 times. Sometimes I was told you're a Punjabi and you're Ulmatol, so you can't. We've got you out of that, but you try again next year. The point here is to be real with yourself. So I strived hard and I said, I have to get it. So a few years later, I tried again. They said, you have to do graduation. I wasn't a graduate. I became a graduate. I tried again, failed again. So what's the point of keep trying is the spirit that we women need to have. So after graduation, there was a time when I said, I'm a graduate, I have become the criteria that's needed to become an air hostess, and I applied for Royal Jordanian, for Cathay Pacific, and Saudia. And I remember getting into all three. So we women have to do that and prepare ourselves so well that we have the choice to say no to people and have a choice to decide what we want. So I got into the airline that I wanted, which was Royal Jordanian. I flew with them for 3 years, and due to the Gulf War, I had to leave. And then I joined Emirates, the airline, which is still the best today. And I flew for 12 years with them. And that was the best part of my life. Now the funny thing here is, when she introduced me, she talked about Mount Everest, I'm coming to that, is we in those days used to go into the cockpit and look at the mountains from the top. And I remember sitting with one of the captains, and I said, and he said, we were flying over Nepal, going somewhere, and he said, that's the highest mountain on earth, Mount Everest. Little did I know at that time that one day I would scale it. But the seed was born. I had no inkling about trekking, mountaineering, or anything. Anyway, to cut the story short, at 47, my husband and I were sitting at the table. He comes from the Dune School. So he said, you know, it's my bucket list that I want to climb Kilimanjaro. So I said, yeah, please go ahead. You know, we've supported each other. And he said, do you want to come? Because to tick off my bucket list, you want to come. And I said, you know, what do we have to do? Kya karna padega? So he said, we'll have to train, we'll have to lose weight, and we will go. And 4.5 months later, we went. I was nearly 47, my husband was nearly 51. And we scaled the mountain in 2012. That was our first mountain. So we prepared. The passion was there. I saw his passion. It was very driven towards me. And I said, this is good, you know, because outdoors can really, really encourage your mind to think clearly, which is what I would say the ladies here, you're all doing so well, but if you get down out there, outdoors, you'll see your perspective of life and change. Because you're living out of your comfort zone, and you will realize there's more to the arc lights that we have. So we did that, and after that, remember sitting in this small plane and looking out of the window, and we saw Mount Kilimanjaro from there. I told my husband, can you believe it? We climbed that mountain and we're fine, our hands, toes, everything is perfect. And he said, yes. He said, you know what? I think we'll have to do something else again. So we came back to India from Kenya, and the seed of climbing the seven continents was born. My husband's already finished his 7 summits. I have finished 6. And Mount Everest has been my 6th summit. I have one more to go next year, which I'll do hopefully at 54. And this is because the passion is there, preparation is there, and perseverance is there. But before that, I want to tell you the story. This was my second attempt to climb the Mount Everest. Last year, it's a 2-month trip. And in the 2 months, what happens is you keep going up and coming down. And I've been training for the last 6 years. I got really sick at Camp 3, which was 23,500. And I was just a week short of the summit. And can you imagine what was going through my mind? I've spent 51 days on the mountain and now I'm sick. What do I do? And I said, well, you know, if there's life, I can come back and live to tell the story. So I came back and I was really dejected. I was really feeling, oh gosh, I tried. I had to be rescued off the mountain. But you know what? The setbacks gave me a greater opportunity to go back more determined, more trained, and with a never give up attitude. So this year, I scaled the mountain. So I said, that is just my journey. It's not my destination. So it's the same for women here. That is not your full stop. Your life will continue if you continue to have that zeal, the passion, connect with women that have that drive. And my message to all the women here is, let's uplift each other. And let's make each other strong to rule the world. What about it, women? One thing I would say that makes me unstoppable, and age is not a barrier to achieving. Kudos to women power. Thank you so much, Sanjita. Very well spoken.
There are such amazing stories that you women have. I'm a little jittery right now. But I'm going to move on to the next person, who's Dr. Shruti Nagapura. Dr. Shruti is the